I want to talk about the interval of increase and the interval of decrease. So start with the interval of increase. So as your X values, as you're going along, as X is getting larger, right? As you go left to right on the X axis, the Ys are going up. That's increasing. So the classic parabola here, the right half of it is increasing. Okay, you remember that from your IM1 days when we looked at increasing line versus a constant line versus a decreasing line. Same idea what you're doing with the parabola. So it's only the right half of the parabola here that is increasing. And so then the notation we can use for this is, if I use inequality notation, well, x is greater than zero and it's less than infinity. So this is x is greater than zero and x is less than infinity. I wanted to show you that so you see the interval for x going from the smallest value to the largest value. Now you could just say x is greater than zero. That would be true as well for your inequality notation. But for now, I want you to get used to the idea that what values of x are the y's increasing as you move left to right. Okay, and then using interval notation itself, the smallest number is zero. And we don't include the zero because the zero is the vertex value. So that's where it bounces, right? It's coming down, it bounces right there at x is zero. So we're not going to include it. And then infinity, we can't include infinity. That's why we just have parentheses here. All right, the interval decrease, same idea. Now, as x is getting larger, what's going on in the y's? Y's are going down. So x getting bigger, 5, 6, 7, 8, y is going down, 100, 90, 80, 70, and so on, whatever the situation may be. So the left side of the parabola, there is the decreasing, right? That is decreasing. So again, when I ask you the question, what is the interval decrease? The key thing is they're asking you for the x values, and students get this confused every year I teach it. It's very confusing when you're first learning it. Don't want the y values. We're talking about what are the x values that result in y going down, okay? So for inequality notation here, x is greater than negative infinity and x is less than zero, right? That is your interval from zero to negative infinity over here on the left, negative infinity, all right? Again, you could just write this as x is less than zero would be the same thing. I'm trying to show you the bottom end and the top end of it, so you see the interval, okay? The interval notation, again, it goes from negative infinity is your smallest number and all the way to zero, and we only use parentheses because it doesn't include zero, it doesn't include negative infinity. So that's interval notation. This is gonna take you a little bit longer to kind of master. Typically, students struggle with this concept for a while, so if you're feeling a little confused right now, that is normal. It's going to be a success over a number of days.